Hi guys, welcome back to Swampy Druid Game Reviews and More. I'm your host Dustin, and this is the start to the Memorial Day weekend. It is a beautiful day, a couple little clouds here and there, but overall very nice. It's a little warm actually. Got my air conditioning running. I don't know if you may be able to hear it. And I'm on the way home. To start my weekend, probably gonna have to run to the store, grab a few groceries, stuff like that. Hopefully we'll find something to do, a taste test, as well as maybe a little surprise. If I do the surprise I'm thinking of, I will record it. It's kind of cool actually. So anyway, the theme of the video here is Far Cry, the series. We have the new Far Cry 5 trailer supposed to launch today. I checked a little while ago and it had not launched yet that I could find. But, you know, like I said, I was at work and I was only on like a 10-minute break and stuff. So I didn't really get to search very good. But I'm sure as soon as that launches, it will be on YouTube. So maybe already on there by now. I'm sure it'll be up by the time you see this video. I do like the idea that it's going to be Western themed. I'm not a fan of the modern day though. When they said it was going to be a Western, I was very excited. I was thinking more, you know, traditional spaghetti Western, you know, that sort of thing. But now it's going to be like a modern day thing, so I'm guessing more along the lines of like Longmire, if you've ever seen that show, or like Old Country, No Country for Old Men, or whatever it was called. I don't remember. I never actually saw the movie. Just kind of a modern day thing, I guess that'll be all right. I'm sure, you know, Far Cry is a great series. And I thoroughly enjoyed, you know, all of them that I played except for two. I'm sorry if you are a fan of Far Cry 2. Sorry, I'll be able to say it. Sorry if you're a fan of that game. It sucks. Sorry, it does. That one, they try to do like an RPG type deal where the characters have health bars, and it's like it didn't matter that you got a headshot, his health bar was still there. So stealth was like, I mean, maybe it got better after a while, but I truthfully couldn't stand to play it. Yeah, Far Cry 5 being set in like a modern day Western and stuff out in like rural Montana. I think it was like Hope County, which sounds like a good theme for the game. Like I said, I'm not a fan of the whole, you know, modern day thing, but I'm kind of imagining it's like maybe a paramilitary group, you know, like some sort of group of crazy rednecks trying to overthrow the government type deal, you know, like Patriots or whatever they might call themselves. So I'm imagining it's going to be something similar to that. I don't know. The cover made me think that. But I'm super excited for it. I do think it will be great. I can't wait to see the graphics. Because Far Cry 4 and Primal were very, very impressive looking games. It's been, 2 years since the last Far Cry? I'm thinking they took a year break. So, yeah, this is like the second year since, you know, Far Cry Primal came out. So, I'm very excited to see where this is going to go. Let's see. I was wanting to talk to... Apologize. It's been a very long week. I was wanting to talk about the series as a whole, and my picks. I had the first one on PC, and this is back when, this is back in the PS2 era, and Xbox, the original Xbox, and I had the, sorry, I'm having to switch lanes. I had a PC. It was specifically a gaming PC, and for its time, it was very, very impressive. I think I would compare it to PowerEye's probably like a PS3 or, you know, like an Xbox 360. I mean, it has some very impressive power. So my Far Cry that I had for I had it on PC was amazing looking. For its time, there was nothing that could even come close. So graphically, it was just, you know, it wowed me. The actual scope of the game and how it was like a chain of islands and stuff, that also was great, because I remember being on like some lookout tower and stuff, and being able to stop people like swimming in the water like an island away. I remember that was really cool, because they would jump in the boat and come toward the island, and by the time the boat actually got there, it would usually crash because I had already sniped out everybody. And it was just very, very impressive. And then when, you know, the PS3 and the 360 come out, you know, I was like, and they said, oh, Far Cry's coming. Oh, I was excited. I was like, yes, I had a 360 at the time, and I was just super excited. I remember his name was Christopher Michael Bradley Rogers. Yes, I know that was a very long name. He was a very cool guy. He had Far Cry 2 on 360. And me and him, we didn't trade games. I loaned him now. Loan, this is very important. I stress this. Especially if you watch this, Chris Rogers. I loaned him my copy of Civilization Revolution. And he loaned me his Far Cry 2. Far Cry 2 had just came out, by the way. He had it like 3 or 4 days. And he got excited to play Civilization Revolution. The reason I was stressing this loan... I'm sorry about that. The reason I was stressing this loaned him the game is because he would not bring it back. I would ask for it. I'm like, dude, you've had my game a month. Let's, you know, I don't like Far Cry 2. By the way, that's my answer. I hated Far Cry 2. And he's like, oh, I've not beat it with all the different civilizations, every way, on every difficulty. I'm like, dude, that's going to take forever. And finally, after, I think it was like 2 weeks. He was only supposed to borrow it like a couple days. He was supposed to borrow it for like the weekend or something. So after like 2 weeks, I'm like, dude, look, let's just trade. Because Civilization Revolution, I got it for $20. And he was more than willing to trade Far Cry 2, which apparently I can understand why. I hated the game. But anyway, I took it, after we officially traded, I took it to GameStop and traded it in. And I think I got like $25 for it. So I actually made $5 on the deal, but I did lose my Civilization Revolution. I did pick up a game I liked. I can't remember what it was. Still, I mean, just... excuse me, guys. I can't remember what it was, but I remember I traded it. It was just... yeah, I like to tell these little stories. But yes, Far Cry 2 sucked. I hated it. I hated the fact that, oh, you have malaria. So every, you know, like so often, it's like, you're going to be sick, and you ain't going to be able to do anything. You're going to pass out. Unless you find the malaria pills, which were few and far between in the area I was, anyway. So, I keep dropping this camera. Hold on, I'm there. Now we got it situated. Sorry about that. So, anyway, we're going to move past Far Cry 2 because I've already wasted enough time on Far Cry 2. Actually, playing it for 5 minutes was wasting too much time on Far Cry 2. I just hated that. I mean, it was a good concept. It had a good story. I hated that health bar thing. Oh, it was stupid. Anyway, then Far Cry 3 came out. It looked good. I was very curious about it. I was very impressed with the graphics. Everybody kept talking about how good it was, but I heard the same thing about Far Cry 2. So it took me a long time before I would give it a chance, because Far Cry 2 burnt me pretty bad. So I finally did give it a chance, and you know, I was very impressed with it. The story, the graphics, just everything. The gameplay was what really sold it. That gameplay was sweet, and that's the formula they've stuck with since then. I did not. Sorry, guys, I hit the rumble strip. I did not beat Far Cry 3. I was at the very end, and I was searching for I was looking for a collectible or something. I think I was trying to find all the collectibles. I was trying to get a 100% on it, and I got on a video on YouTube, and he was showing where to find the collectibles. And he said, "Oh yeah, guys, by the way," and he shows the ending of Far Cry. Doesn't tell you it's the ending until after you've watched it. So he spoiled it. Like I said, I was right at that point. And so I really did. I was very mad. I actually just quit playing it at that point. So this is actually turning into a pretty long video. But Far Cry is a series that I do love. So, Far Cry 3 was excellent. Far Cry 4, truthfully, I didn't play 4 for a while. I think it was actually out for like 2 years, maybe a year and a half. And truth be told, I know this is stupid, the guy's hair on the front of Far Cry 4, Pagan Men, this blonde-headed, bleached blonde-headed guy wearing like a pimp suit. That's the reason I didn't play it. I thought it looked ridiculous. I thought, man, that is the dumbest looking villain ever. He looks like a guy from like an Austin Powers movie. And so literally, I didn't play it just because I thought it was ridiculous looking. I thought, man, really? This is the main villain, this pimp wannabe? Anyway. I actually played it eventually. My wife like, yeah, you need to try it. You need to play it. You like 3, you need to try it. So, she talked me into it. I bought it, and wow, Far Cry 4. That was a game. Pagan Men is the name of the guy. Ridiculous looking guy in the pimp suit, by the way. He was an excellent villain. I love that he taunted you the entire game. Reminded me of Handsome Jack from the Borderlands series. He just kept talking and kept talking. Let's just be upfront and honest about it. You cannot judge a book by its cover. You cannot judge a game by its ridiculous looking villain. So anyway, Far Cry Primal came out. I saw when they officially told what the game, you know, they officially announced it. They launched the trailer. I was sold instantly. I grew up in the 80s. So we... Caveman was big in the 80s. The Flintstones. I mean, you know, the Flintstones have been off the air for a while, but they brought the Flintstone Kids. There was a lot of Caveman stuff in the 80s. And so I loved the idea that they went prehistoric. The saber-toothed tigers, the mammoths, all that, the giant bears, I was thrilled, and I really enjoyed it. Far Cry Primal was excellent. I was actually talking with my line leader at work. He didn't like it, but that's his opinion. You know, he didn't like it, and I can see, you know, that theme is not for everyone. But I loved it. I remember riding into like the enemy camps on the back of a saber-toothed tiger shooting fire arrows, and it looked something like, you know, from a AAA, you know, movie, like that 10,000 BC movie or something. I mean, it wowed me. I mean, I was thrilled with it. So, anyway, this video is approaching 15 minutes long, so I'm going to actually just sum up here. In the order that I like Far Cry, the series, Far Cry 4 was my favorite, followed by Primal, and then Far Cry 3, and then 2, or Far Cry 3, and then 1. And I'm not even putting two on the list. So, I know that's not fair, but I'm not putting it on the, you know, it's dead last for sure, you know. Like I said, if someone gave me a copy, I might use it for a coaster or something. But, I might mess around with it, I guess. But, you know, it'd be one of those things I wouldn't pay good money for. That's how much I disliked it. But anyway, guys, this is just kind of a summary of the Far Cry series, you know, and just kind of my experience with it. I loved Far Cry. It was a great, you know, the series is just great. Can't wait to see what they do with Far Cry 5. I would prefer the Old West, but, you know, we got a modern day Western. And like I said, they've not disappointed me since Far Cry 2, so I'm super excited for it. So anyway, guys, this is Dustin for Swampy Druid Game Reviews. If you like the content, hit that like, subscribe, all that good stuff. It's Labor Day, or Memorial Day weekend, sorry. I'm going to be uploading a lot of videos, some taste tests, lots of gameplay, lots of videos all weekend long. Sorry, I was looking at, there's a dog in the road. Lots and lots of videos this weekend. So I plan on launching all those. Got the new format coming next week. I'm going to start working on getting that stuff set up. And anyway, guys, like, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I will catch you in the next video. You guys have a good weekend. Drive safe. And see you in the next video. Bye.